So I see so many people making these mistakes, and I'm just like, honey, cariño, please stop.
Welcome or welcome back to Folklorista's Corner, the ultimate place for new folkloristas. I'm your host, Carmen Flores, and today we are talking about folklorico mistakes to avoid. Mistake numero uno. Not researching your instructor. Why is this such a big deal and why is it important? Many different factors, but the very first factor point that I want to make is that your dance instructor is going to affect your dance training, which is going to affect you as a dancer physically and mentally. So, if you're not getting proper dance training, many things are going to happen. A, you're going to increase your chances of injury if your instructor has no idea of the importance of a warm-up, cool-down, and understanding difficulty levels, how much to push, when to stop, when to take breaks, etc., that every dance instructor needs to know in order, or coach, depending, right? Which is very important because you want. Hopefully, if you want to go pro or not, you want to be able to dance and do other activities. So you want to make sure you're getting proper training because dance uses different parts of your body that we normally would not use on the daily, which is the importance of technique, therefore dance training. Second point, you want to be able to grow as a person, whether you want to pursue being a dancer or not, and that ultimately, your teacher is going to affect a big part of that. I have been a part of many different groups, and there's some groups that I wish I would have done my due diligence and researched more because really a lot of my instructors, whether they realized it or not, have affected my self-esteem and my confidence to a degree. At times, and there's been times where I didn't feel the best because of how I was being treated and things that were going on. And I am forever grateful for my current instructors, also my college dance instructors, because it really changed my perspective, how I feel about myself, and really gave me a lot of confidence. And now I kind of want to pursue going pro, which has been something I never considered doing because of my dance training. So you want to avoid all that and you want to ensure that you're going to benefit the most at the end of the day because you're paying money to go train, to go be part of a team, and you want your money's worth out of it. And personally for me, you want personally for me, I want to work with qualified instructors so that I could be the best that I could possibly be. Error numero dos. Not investing in quality dance shoes. Hear me out. Ugh, this is gonna cost. Hear me out. First year in, if you're dabbling into it, you're not too sure. It's okay to buy the lower end, the ones at the swap meet, or the ones that don't have too many nails, or the ones that are not too high, because you don't know if you're going to be wanting to do this next year. You don't know how much you're gonna like it, or maybe you dislike it, or maybe you want to pursue it, or maybe not. So I say the first year, it's okay to get cheaper shoes, but when you're set, when you're decided that you're gonna do this for a while, you want to invest in good quality shoes. And here's why. You want to avoid the scenario of your heels breaking. And how does that happen? Poor quality made shoes. If you get better quality made shoes, you're not gonna have that happen. Second point, you're gonna end up spending more money in the long run if you don't invest in your shoes. So, for an instance, we're just going to use the shoes that I got my dance group because budget cuts and, well, not budget cuts, but because of our budget and because they're beginners and I don't know if they're going to pursue it or not, I didn't want to invest so much. I went to the swap meet and I got the shoes from there because, again, I don't know how serious these people are going to be and I don't want to put too much money down up front right away. Literally within a year. And we were dancing on a classroom floor, so not even concrete. So these shoes kind of lasted a year, maybe 2 years, and then they just, no, not even 2 years, it was like a year. They were already worn out. The nails, I mean, I knew what I was getting myself into because there wasn't that many nails to begin with. The shoes worn out within a year. And it is just like, you know, if we do the math.
All right, here's our example. You purchase a pair, $45 pair of shoes. They wear out every year and you dance for about 4 years. So 4 times 45 is 180. Now we're not even considering if you have to replace more or faster due to a heel breaking off or it wears out faster. So let's just estimate throughout this 4 years, you buy an extra 2 pair more, which would be an approximate total of $270. Versus if you would have gone with the professional shoes, dancing around the same amount of time, you would have just spent $135. They would have lasted longer and your approximate total savings would have been $135.
It's not worth the stress, the headache, the money, and the time to be buying poorly made shoes because it's going to just affect your mood. You're going to be on stage performing and then a heel breaks. How are you going to feel? You're not going to feel too good. You're going to be feeling embarrassed and annoyed and like, oh, my heel freaking broke, right? So let's prevent that. Let's get serious. Let's invest. Let's save up some money and invest on a good pair of dance shoes. And now I know the rebuttal. I know people are going to say, oh, but it's too much money, this and that. Again, if you genuinely want to go pro, if you genuinely want to dance, you will invest into that. If you could invest money into a Disneyland ticket that's like around that same price or more, depending on how many people, like, it's just priorities. At the end of the day, what are your priorities? I'm just mentioning this because personally for me, for my preference, I rather invest in that money, get shoes that are to my size. So literally the place where I go, they custom make the shoes. I go to Duran's dance shoes in Boyle Heights. For me, it's worth it. My shoes have lasted me 8 freaking years. They're starting to like really wear out where I need to go replace them and get new ones. I haven't had any issues with the heels falling off. Been very comfortable, very long-lasting, durable shoes, and I'm glad I invested the money into it.
Error número tres, not having a doble vuelo practice skirt. Why do we need to have a doble vuelo practice skirt?
I feel that it's much better just to have that type of skirt with the extra fabric because that's basically what it is. It's basically a full circle skirt because if you're going to be practicing regions, something like Nayeri, which requires you to go all the way up, or if you're going to end up doing something like Veracruz where it's, you know, kind of midway, by your waist, you don't want to have a different type of skirt. You don't want to have to carry an extra type of skirt. It's just much easier, saves you money as well to just have one skirt that does it all. It's a two-in-one type of deal.
Error número cuatro,
not wearing proper dance attire. This one irritates me so much, and I will forever keep bringing it up until it's no longer an issue. But why do we need to have proper dance attire? Multiple reasons. Very first one, let's make our instructor's life easier because, again, they have to do a lot of stuff. They have to prep choreo. They're probably doing everything themselves. You want to try to help them out. And an instructor needs to be able to see your body clearly in order to make corrections. And if you're wearing baggy clothing, it's not going to be easy for your instructor to tell if you're doing the step right or wrong. Like, it's not gonna be easy for them to correct you because they're not really seeing what's going on. There's a reason why there's dance leotards and dance wear. It's so that your instructor could see your body easily, be able to correct you right there in your spot. So ultimately, by the time you do a performance, you're dancing gracefully and beautifully. And if you're wearing loose clothing like this, it's going to be harder for you to get those corrections, for you to improve as a dancer. Second reason is that it builds discipline. Now, as a dancer, unless you're a soloist, but most of these groups tend to do duets, trios, etc., mostly group type of dances, you want to be as unison as possible. And that's all, honestly, starts with discipline, with building
that habit of getting dressed into proper dance wear. And with that, you're also preparing your mind. You're like, okay, I'm getting ready for practice. You're taking, I see it as me time. I see it as a sign of respect, not only to myself, but to my instructor and to my class, my dance mates, that, hey, I'm taking this serious. I want you guys to also take it serious so that we could all improve and that we could do the best that we can. So that's another reason why. And another rebuttal I've heard is that it's too expensive. Well, there's places, there's brands like Discount Dance, Dancewear Solutions. There are affordable places. Again, it's priorities at the end of the day if you're willing to do that or not. Also, wearing proper dancewear, it's going to help you improve on your technique. Because if I were to wear this to practice, and if we're doing, I don't know, some type of ballet, if we're doing some type of dance drill, this is going to get in the way. This is going to distract me. I'm going to be too focused trying to fix this so I could execute whatever we're learning. It's going to be a distraction. And I'm just, my mind mentally is not going to be focused on the drill, focused on learning the choreo, etc. Because I'm being distracted. And that's the whole purpose of dancewear, is so that you could improve on your technique, so you can improve as a dancer, so you could build the discipline, and so you could show that sign of respect for your instructor who's taking the time out of their day to teach you how to dance. Error numero cinco. Focusing way too much or relying way too much on your music, on the music, or your dance mates when it comes to dancing, and not learning the sets, the sequences, or the choreo yourself. So, I've seen instances, and it has happened, where there's been technical difficulties with the music, and you know, some groups keep going and some don't, because they didn't learn the sequences, they didn't learn the steps, or they didn't learn the counts. And this is another reason why we have to learn it. We also need to learn as dancers the sequences and the steps ourselves, is that what are you gonna do if you have to substitute for somebody and you don't know it? Well, then you're letting down your whole team, right? So we have to take the responsibility as dancers to not rely on anybody else. What if we're following someone, they make a mistake? Are we going to also follow their mistake? No, you're going to, if you know the step, you're going to keep going. You're going to keep doing the correct thing. You're probably going to notice, most likely, that your dance mate made a mistake while it happens. But you don't want it to be a whole chain reaction. It's just the overall performance is just not gonna look good if we're doing that. So it's the responsibility for us dancers to really know our sequences, our steps, and to not rely on music or other dance mates, because life happens, things happen, and we have to be responsible for ourselves. Error numero seis, and this is the most annoying one for me, it's like my pet peeve. But it's making noise when your instructor is going over a step or is demoing a step. And what do I mean by making noise? Whether you're talking, whether, I understand you trying to do the step, but when your instructor is showing you how to do the step, don't make any noise at all. Just watch. If you have to, mark it with your hand gesture. So if I'm doing zapateo de tres, if I'm doing a huachapial or whatever, just mark it with your hand, because you want to show respect to your instructor and to your dance mates. It's very disrespectful when someone's talking and you're making noise, right? So we want to be respectful of the time that your instructor is taking out of their day to, again, to come and teach you, and to your dance mates who genuinely want to learn. And they can't concentrate because you're on the side making side noises, side commentaries, whatever. It's very disrespectful. And we need to work on that. And, you know, it happens to the best of us. Sometimes we get a little carried away. Sometimes we get excited. We really want to do it. But we need to also show respect for our instructor and for our dance. Let me know what you think about these mistakes below. Have you done any? Or do you have any mistakes that we should be aware of? Genuinely curious, let's have a conversation in the comments down below. I really hope that you keep dancing. Good luck on your journey, and I'll see you next time. Adios.